So good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the class on measure of dispersion. Already we are discussing about the scenario in the normal distribution curve. Guys, always remember, whatever we are discussing here, everything follow normal distribution curve. So under the normal distribution curve, we have studied about measure of central tendency. So the measure of central tendency talked about finding the average of the data. Whenever we have a data which is normally distributed, okay, so in that normally distributed data, it is a symmetrical distribution pattern. In the case of normal distribution, this is called as mesocurtic. Okay, so in this symmetrical normal distribution pattern, so we believe that the maximum data will aggregate at the center, which we call as the average, and the average we calculate by different means. We follow mean, we follow median, we follow mode, where the relation between mean, median, mode is equal to 3 median minus 2 mean. Then when I talk about mean, mean can be arithmetic mean, geometric mean, or harmonic mean, where you should know that the square of geometric mean is equal to arithmetic mean into harmonic mean. You should know that mode is equal to 3 times of median minus 2 times of arithmetic mean. You should know all this. I believe more or less you know this. Just trying to reinforce the same concept. So in the case of normal distribution pattern, whatever we are doing is a normal distribution pattern. Please remember, in the case of normal distribution, okay, not all the data would be there at the center. There would be a property of the data that data may disperse from the center. That is what we called as a measure of dispersion. So when we are trying to study a measure of dispersion, measure of dispersion basically measures the risk, measures the scenario of dispersion of the data which may aggregate around the center. So there are around 66%, around 66.73, around 66% is the probability that your data will disperse. 66% of is the probability that your data will disperse in plus minus of one standard deviation. Okay, then we'll say that around 95% is the probability that your data will disperse. Around 95% is the probability that your data will lies in the plus minus of two standard deviation. Okay, the standard deviation is basically the parameter which measures the dispersion of the data, which measures how much data is dispersed from the center. Okay, so where we'll say that there's a 99.73% is the probability that your data will lie in the plus minus of three standard deviation. So standard deviation, you can see the sigma sign. So standard deviation is basically the parameter out of all measured dispersion, which mainly talk about how the dispersion happens. So whenever we talk about dispersion, in dispersion, we have studied about absolute measure of dispersion. In dispersion, we have studied about absolute measure of dispersion. In absolute measure of dispersion, we have studied about range. Okay, we have studied about quartile deviation. We have studied about range. We have studied about quartile deviation. We have studied about variance. Okay, or standard deviation. Variance is the square of standard deviation. Remember this variance. When we say variance is the square of standard deviation, I hope everyone remembers. Variance is the square of standard deviation. So whenever we say variance is the square of standard deviation. Then we have to study mean deviation. Okay, then we have to study mean deviation. These are the terms that we measure in absolute measure dispersion. We study about them. In relative measure dispersion, if I talk about relative measure of dispersion, if I talk about relative measure of dispersion, if I'm talking about relative measure of dispersion, okay, if I'm talking relative measure dispersion, there we study coefficient of range. In relative measure dispersion, there we study coefficient of range. Coefficient of range is highest value minus lowest value divided by highest value plus lowest value into 1. This is called coefficient of range. Then the next thing what we study is the coefficient of variance. Very important, right? This term is very important. Coefficient of variance. Coefficient of variance is standard deviation by mean 200. Coefficient of variance. So every year the question comes in Bangalore City based on coefficient of medians. Last year also numerical came on coefficient of medians. 100% you'll get a numerical on coefficient of variance. The formula coefficient of variance, very important, is standard deviation. The coefficient of variance formula is standard deviation by mean into standard. The coefficient of variance formula is standard deviation by mean into 100. Coefficient of range is highest value minus lowest value divided by highest plus lowest value into 100. Then the third thing what we need to study here is the coefficient of quartile deviation. Coefficient of quartile deviation Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1 into 100. That is coefficient of quartile deviation. So Q3, Q1, you know that lower quartile, upper quartile, you know it visible. So you know the terms coefficient of range, coefficient of variance, coefficient of quartile deviation. Then the next thing you should know is the coefficient of mean deviation. Then the next thing what we need to study is the coefficient of mean deviation. If I'm talking of coefficient of mean deviation, then the formula for the coefficient of mean deviation is basically mean deviation. Coefficient of mean deviation, basically the formula is mean deviation divided by average. The average can be mean, median, mode, geometric mean, harmonic mean. Any average that they may give you in the problem. Right. Calculate the coefficient of mean deviation by this method, that method. You can do that, and with this you'll get the coefficient of mean deviation. That is mean deviation divided by average into 100. They'll ask to calculate the coefficient of mean deviation by using a more median method. So the average there would be median. Clear, everyone? Clear, everyone? Anyone have any doubt?
Anyone? No, sir.
Okay. Anyone can explain me quartile deviation formula? Can anyone tell me the formula of quartile deviation? How we calculate?
Q3 minus Q1 by 2.
How will you calculate Q3 and Q1?
3 into 6max. Okay. 3 into n plus.
Guys, whenever anyone asks you like this kind of formula, you have to ask them, sir, what kind of formula you want to leave? Raw database formula or class interval with frequency formula? So if you ask me, sir, raw database formula, then quartile, decile, percentile, median, all belong to the same family. So first thing what we do there, we arrange the data in ascending order. Then for the median, the formula is n plus 1 by 2. Observation quartile is n plus 1 by 4 into 1. Quartile 3 is n plus 1 by 4 into 3. Okay, like this will calculate the values. You give me class interval with frequency, then for quartile, decile, percentile, median, we follow the formula that L plus H by F in bracket N into sum of F by 4 minus CF. I hope you remember. So if I give you class interval with frequency for quartile 1, you will follow the formula L plus H by F sum of F by 4 minus CF. How will you find the value of L, H, F and all? For that, first thing what you will do, first thing only before this calculation, you'll find sum of F by 4. And then you'll see in less than cumulative frequency table, you'll see the next value which is bigger than sum of F by 4. And that would be the selected data. Similarly for Q3, what you'll do, your formula is L plus H by F into 3 into sum of F by 4 minus CF. And before doing this calculation, you'll find 3 into sum of F by 4. And then you'll see in less than cumulative frequency, the next value bigger than 3 into sum of F by 4. Clear, everyone? Anyone, any doubt? Anyone, any doubt?
1 by 4. No.
So one by one, if I explain you quartile deviation, you know very well. Quartile deviation formula is Q3 minus Q1 by 2. Already explained you how to find the value of quartiles. Okay, now talking about range. Range is nothing but it is a difference between highest value minus lowest value. Coefficient of range formula will be highest minus lowest divided by highest plus lowest into 100. So with this, you can find range also. You can find coefficient of range also. Okay, this equation kind of question, I don't mind doing it, but again, I don't think it will be important for you to understand. These are all more important for other students who want to prepare for higher competitive exams. So I'll not discuss more on that equation kind of question. Range of y is modulus of regression coefficient of range of x. For that, I'll not do that. So if you see this example 11.2.2, everyone, can you see this question?
No, sir. Okay. Yes, sir.
If I ask you what is a range, so guys, you need to understand range formula is highest value minus lowest value. Next thing you need to understand that these class intervals are not continuous. So before you take any value of a range, so your lower limit would be 49.5, your upper limit would be 75.5. Be careful with that part. Because you can see here the class intervals are not continuous. So here you need to make the data continuous. So how will you make continuous? I hope you know by this time. So your range would be 74.5 minus 49.5. That would be 25. And then if I ask you coefficient of range, that would be highest minus lowest divided by highest plus lowest into. Clear, everyone? Any doubt, anyone?
No, sir.
So this is a mean deviation formula. If I give you raw data, then simple. Again, whenever anybody asks any formula, you have to ask them what formula you are looking for with raw data or with class interval and frequency. So if I talk about mean deviation, so if I give you raw data, then your formula is sum of x minus x bar by n. So simple formula. I hope you know this sign. I hope this means all values should be positive. Okay. Otherwise, I believe you should know by this. It's a question of statistics that sum of x minus x bar is 0. Okay, that is a property. Okay, sum of x minus x bar is 0. Now here I want not sum of x minus x bar. I want modulus of x minus x bar. So the modulus of x minus x bar is different from sum of the modulus of x minus x bar is different from the sum of x minus x bar, because there here both positive sign can come and here both negative sign can come. They'll cancel each other to become, but here modulus means only positive value is x. So if I give you raw data, this is your formula. While if I give you class interval with frequency, then the formula of mean deviation would be sum of f x minus x bar divided by sum of, this is a formula if I give you class interval with frequency. I'll explain you this, don't worry on this, don't, by looking at the formula don't get scared and all, so don't worry on that part. I'll explain you everything. So if I give you raw data, then mean deviation formula is different. If I give you class interval frequency, mean deviation formula is different. So this is the formula based on this. Let do some numerical to make you understand this. So suppose if I have taken some data, some raw data, 5, 8, 10, 10, 12, 9. Okay, so if I'm asking you what is the mean deviation, okay, of these numbers, so you simply write down the number, find the average, okay, find x minus average, do the sum of that. That is 10, and then you apply the formula. What is the formula of mean deviation about median, about arithmetic? Simple formula, guys. Find the modulus of x minus x bar. Modulus basically means you only accept the positive value. All output will be positive. Irrespective of your positive, if your output is positive or negative. So in case of mean deviation, you are putting modulus sign, means output is always positive. Any doubt, anyone?
No, sir.
Try this question. If you see in this problem, how you need to do, you have to find mean deviation. So the formula of mean deviation here, raw data is given, is summation of modulus x minus x bar. So the x bar is average. That x bar, what is the average, you will take as the median. I hope you know how to find median of this data. How will you find the median of this data, guys?
Arrange in the ascending
order. Arrange these numbers in ascending order.
You arrange the data in ascending order, then the median formula is n plus 1 by 2. That much observation, you'll apply that formula. You'll get the median. And here, for doing the calculation purpose, average you'll take as a median. Because in the question it is given, you have to calculate the mean deviation about median. Only one person is given answer. What were others? So here, if I'm asking you about mean deviation, coefficient of mean deviation, remember the formula. The formula of coefficient of mean deviation is mean deviation divided by average into 100. So because you calculated the mean deviation by median method, so average here would be the median. Clear, everyone?
Yes, sir.
See this question. Everyone. This example 14.2.6, everyone please write it down this question.